My name is R. Crosby Lyles, and this is News from the Can. Earlier today, this Secure Team 10 video came across my feed. Apparently, the people of Nags Head, North Carolina, woke up to find a 10-foot cliff where the beach used to be. This isn't news to anyone living on the East Coast. I've seen the beach ripped away by wind-driven currents many times since the 70s. It's nothing new. A quick peek at the USGS Coastal Change Hazard Portal will show red dots along the coast that cluster around Savannah, Nags Head, up the Virginia coast, Atlantic City, and all the way up to Pleasant Bay, Massachusetts. All of this would be happening even if the AMOC wasn't shutting down. The reason I took notice of this particular event is because it may indicate what to expect from a change in the North Atlantic Gyre. It looks like the part of the gyre right off the eastern seaboard might be collapsing into a system of smaller vortices. This would explain the large accumulation of sargasso seaweed in places it doesn't usually accumulate and the erosion of beach where it doesn't usually erode. Our weakening geomagnetic field may be partly to blame for the shift, as the magnetic field can enhance or suppress vortex production depending on the angle of incident to the fluid flow. See my video, Magnetic Field Effects on Ocean Currents, for more about this phenomenon. So what does this mean? Well, it may mean that we end up with a slightly smaller North Atlantic version of the Pacific blob anomaly that occurred between 2013 and 2015 with similar super persistent high pressure ridge and high sea surface water temperatures. This would necessarily produce a warmer than usual winter for New England and a colder than usual winter for Europe, as the persistent winds would swing clockwise around the high pressure. It will also mean wet conditions for the southeast, with continued heavy beach erosion up the east coast from Florida to Massachusetts. The coast of France and Spain may also have persistent high wind, waves, and colder sea surface temperatures. The emphasis is on persistence. This kind of setup makes for a very cold and nasty winter for most of Europe. Catastrophic amounts of frozen precipitation are always a possibility. As always, don't take my word for it. Do your own research and consult with your favorite weather people. It never hurts to be prepared. A citizen's band or ham radio might be nice to have around, as well as extra provisions and a well-ventilated generator. And that's about it for now. My name is R. Crosby Lyles, and this has been News from the Can. Stay safe and stay tuned. If you like this content, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you.